why did you guys choose? Like, what was the reason why you chose that sign? Why did you want to be there when you graduated? What was the reasoning going through your head when you thought about it? Yeah.
Because when you're on the
So what can you do to help make sure that, like, what can you do to strengthen yourself by yourself?
Stay confident. Because you're tired, right? Because you do fun things the night before. You go to the football game. You hang out with friends. You do whatever, right? So why can't we make our faith fun? Girls. Why can't we make our faith fun? Well, why can't you be serious? Do you play any sports? Yeah. You cheer? Why is cheering fun? You gonna mess around? Why can't you mess around in your faith? Because you can. That's why I'm asking. Everyone makes faith seem like it's so hard to get along with. But I know there's a few of you here that have been to Catholic youth camp, have you not? Why do you guys have fun at Catholic youth camp and not at St. Teresa's Mass? Make it fun? Okay, what else? Music's fun? No, fake. Fake. Why is your fake fun at CYC? Because they have fun songs.
Fun songs, okay. But the reason I keep going back isn't because, like, most kids go back because they keep missing camp. I'm at camp every weekend. I leave Friday, go to camp, come home Sunday, every single weekend. So it's not that I don't miss camp. But the reason I go back is because we get to share the fun faith with you guys.
but we challenge you guys to bring it home. How many of you can play a musical instrument? How many of you can sing? I never said well. How many of you like to sing? Okay, now look around at all the hands. Guys, take this seriously right here. Look around at all the hands. Each one of you is different, right? God made each of you different. God came down to show us all the gifts and talents that he had for us. And that's what makes our faith fun. We have to share our talents with everyone around us. We used to have a life team mass here at St. Teresa's 4:30 on Sunday. Sunday night, 4:30 mass used to be the life team mass. Fourth Sunday of every month. We would have the life team kids sing in the choir, play the instruments, drums, the whole nine yards. Why'd that go away? We weren't having people participate. People were getting busy. But we can bring that back. We can share God's love with everyone around us in little ways. There's so many of you that said, oh, camp mass is fun. We get to move around. We get to sing fun songs. We may not get to move around as much here at St. Teresa's, but we can still sing the fun songs. You look on my playlist, one of my playlists, I have every camp mass music we own. I don't play guitar that well, but I can play some of the camp songs. So there's little ways we can share God's love with us all around us. And that is what the second chapter is about that I'm teaching tonight. We have to be able to show God's love to everyone around us. Whether it is smiling at them in the hall, saying hello. I mean, how many of you can go through a really bad day and someone just says hi and smiles at you and you kind of feel a little better about the day? Yeah, right? A smile can bring happiness to people around you. So why don't we just, Fernando, why don't we just smile at everyone and show him the love that we do? I'm going to play a song for you guys right now, and I want you to listen to the lyrics of the song. It's a song by Matthew West. It is called, Do Something. I want you to just call it something. It's called Do Something. I want you guys to listen to the lyrics, and then we're going to talk about the song afterwards, and then I'll be done. But I can keep talking all night if we're not going to pay attention. And I'm sure you don't want to listen to me talk all night. No, we're going to be done with the proclaim, and then we're going to go to song groups and the fun stuff. We have fun stuff. So, pay attention. We're going to have a nice conversation afterwards, and then we'll go into some more groups, okay?
Just couldn't bear the thought of people living in poverty.
Why do you guys think I wrote those three lines from the song up here? Why do you think I put God, why don't you do something? So what we always lean towards. How many times have you guys prayed to God and be like, hey, it'd be really awesome if you fix, heal my aunt or grandma who's really sick right now? How many times have we said a prayer of healing? How many times did we skip mass? We followed up with like a negative, right? No, absolutely, I've missed mass before. Like, you guys, it happens. I understand that. But when we go with these problems, these, God, you fix it. You do it. Always using you's instead of I statements. It kind of defeats the purpose of why God put us here. God put us here to help change the world around us and to help make everyone else healthy and bright and beautiful with everything. Why do you think I put I created you up there? Yeah, no. Exactly. He created us to be here on this earth to help fix the problems around us. The first few lines in the song is, this isn't word for word, but I'm tired of looking at all the poverty around us. Does it make any of you sad that there's children in Africa dying? There's people in Des Moines homeless that don't have a shelter during the winter. But what are we doing to fix it? If this last line, if not us, then who? If not me, then you, not who. Yeah. Exactly. If we don't take that first step, how do we know anyone else is going to do something? This is probably one of the most important lines in this song that I want you guys to take back. Take it to small groups, talk about it, and then take it home. And you can take it to the most simplest form of, hey, if that cup is sitting on the counter at home, if I don't move it, will it ever get in the dishwasher? We can hope, yes. But then, if the cup sits there for 2 days, 3 days, is mom going to yell at you for not taking the cup and putting it in the dishwasher? Or dad going to yell at you for not taking the cup and putting it in the dishwasher? So if we were to take that first step and grab that cup and put it in the dishwasher, we wouldn't be getting yelled at, right? Same concept with our faith and with our love of God. If we don't take that first step towards Him, why should He overextend and reach out and help us? It's a two-way street with God. He's always going to be there for us no matter what, but we have to reach out for Him. He's always reaching for us. Each and every day, He's reaching out for us and trying to help us. We just have to be able to reach back into Him. Okay? The last thing is this little, I don't want to call it a story, it's kind of more of a poem, and it's called If Jesus Was Not God, okay? If Jesus was not God, Christmas and Easter would be fairy tales, if they existed at all. Michelangelo wouldn't have had a ceiling to paint, and hundreds of the world's greatest works of art would disappear. Sunday would just be football day. Mother Teresa would have been just another old lady. Mary would have just been another Jewish peasant girl. All the apostles would have kept their day jobs. Blessed Pope John Paul II would have remained Carol Wintinia, Polish, and become a Polish actor. The civil rights movement would not have had Reverend Martin Luther King Jr. as a leader. The Catholic Church would not exist. Your sin would never have been forgiven. There would be no Eucharist and no Mass. The saints and martyrs would have died for nothing. Heaven would not have been an option, and death would be everlasting. I want you guys to think about those few words that when we go to small groups and maybe talk about them in your small groups with believers. There's things in there that we find funny, like Sunday would be football day. But then there's other things like the saints and martyrs, they would have died for nothing. And heaven would not exist, and death would be everlasting. So when you guys go to small groups, I want you to think about all that and talk about it with your group. Hey, Monica, Trick, do you guys have a sign that